It's the NFL on EA Sports. And if it's in the game, it's in the game. It's the Bucks and the Lions, and it comes your way next.
Downtown between Brush Street and I-375. That's where we're located in the heart of Detroit at Ford Field, which first opened back in 2002. Straight ahead, we've got a pretty good one on tap here, as it'll be the Tampa Bay Buccaneers taking on the Detroit Lions. Brandon Gaudin alongside Charles Davis. Before kickoff, Charles, quickly, your keys to the game.
Well, partner, I could give you the standard ones, turnovers, special teams play. But here's one that doesn't get talked about much anymore, and that's time of possession. Whoever controls the football, gives their defense a break, and takes care of business, that's the team that's going to win this ball game.
Here's the former Illini kicker, Chase McLaughlin, to get us started. And we are underway from Ford Field. And this will go as a touchback, and they will begin things at the 25. So here are the Lions now coming out for their opening drive. They'll be led out by the first overall selection of the 2016 draft. From Cal, it's Jared Goff.
I tell you what, when he is on schedule for that week, secondaries take notice, because you've got to stay alert back there on every snap. A truly powerful arm, one that's capable of challenging any level of the defense on any given play. That's why so many scouts preach arm talent when preparing for the NFL draft. A quarterback with arm strength to make every throw in the book, he's an asset to have in any offense.
Right to the air, here is Goff. St. Brown. And they work this well upfield across the 45. A well-executed 22-yard gain. And we see the emphasis early here. Get your star receiver involved, able to do it successfully.
Not a bad start to begin with, that's for sure. And to me, this play says our guy is better than your guy's. Because, you know, a player of his stature, he won't just be single covered all game long. Still be involved multiple people. And right away, they told the other team, guess what? He's just better.
Another first down, this time on a gain of 19.
Not only have they completed a couple on this drive, but they peeled off some pretty good chunks of yardage, too.
Absolutely. Great start. Two nice plays in the pass game. Now can they continue to feed off that? They will run for the first time with David Montgomery. This will be a gain of about 8 to the 27-yard line. If these kinds of lanes are available, you have to feel like he's going to have a pretty big game on the ground.
Yeah, you can tell early on he's got a little burst in his step, and that's a big pickup right there on first down.
Now a second and 2. Again, they'll go ground with Montgomery. And he'll be a couple yards shy of the red zone here at the 22-yard line. So that time they get the tight end on the hold.
Normally he's a pretty good run blocker, but this time he just didn't get his arms extended and let go quickly enough. The flag came out as a result.
Goff. Open man right side of St. Brown. Before they're inside the 25. Goff to St. Brown for the Detroit first down. That early game script that they drew up is working pretty well here on this first drive. Already in field goal range, Charles, knocking on the door of the red zone.
You know, Brandon, when we met with the coaching staff, they kind of predicted that they would come out firing like this. I think you and I were a little skeptical that it'd be this easy, but they certainly knew what they were doing in scouting, in preparation, and understanding what their team was capable of.
It's another first down as they look his way again, this time 19 yards.
A lot of precision being shown on this opening drive. They've been methodical, they've been crisp, and as a reward, they're going to be set up with an early first and goal.
A terrific opening drive has them knocking on the door, first and goal. Montgomery will struggle to get to the line of scrimmage as he'll be tackled back at the 4-yard line. They'll say no gain on the play, and it'll be second and goal.
Absolutely love the effort there. The ability to flow from his inside spot and stop that one at the line of scrimmage. Nice linebacker play.
Line of scrimmage, again the 4-yard line, second and goal. Once more Montgomery. Yeah, this time he'll get down close to the goal line, but not quite in as he stopped at the 1-yard line. They get 3 yards closer, but still work to do. It's third and goal. Driven it down the field nicely here on the opening drive, and now it's put up or shut up.
No doubt about it, because to make that type of a drive and ultimately kick a field goal would feel very disappointing. But I'm just wondering, is the head coach thinking, is this 4-down territory? Might he go for it?
Well, Montgomery just unable to twist free as they hit him short of the line to gain. Nothing doing on that one, and it'll be fourth down. Defense didn't budge on third down. Now, what are we going to see on fourth?
We are soon to find out, but does this feel like old school football or what?
Oh,
right?
Yeah.
This is an old-fashioned goal line stand. I know what I would call on offense. I would go for it. And I want some type of a play where my quarterback has a chance to run it or throw it. I don't just want one static play.
Here we go on fourth. Goff. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. And he is going to be out of bounds, well short of the pylon, and that will be a turnover on downs. They get the completion but cannot push forward into the end zone. And on the opening drive of the ball game, the defense comes up with a goal line stand. So here the Bucs backed up to start their initial drive. Under center, it's the 2017 Heisman Trophy winner as you get a look at Baker Mayfield.
Every quarterback in the NFL has a little bit of his own signature style out there, but for this guy, he really plays the game in a different way. It's led to a couple double takes from us up here as we see him as something truly unique. It's not that he's just the strongest passer or the best athlete to ever play the position. He just has a certain way of seeing the action, and it allows him to make some special plays out there.
They'll start the drive with a give to White, and he will forge his way forward only up to the 2-yard line. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and 9.
Well, he got what he could there, just trying to move forward and gain a little bit of yardage and create some space. You know the pressure is going to be tough defensively.
Second and 9. Opting to run again here with White. Well, that gives him a little room, but not much. A gain of 2 to the 5. Just not a whole lot of room to operate there on that carry.
No, not at all. They did a really nice job staying in their proper places and not allowing any lanes to open up.
They'd like to avoid punting from their own end zone so they could use something here on third down. Now a give up the middle. This is White, able to power through, and he won't quite make it. He needed 6. He got about 5. Fourth down. So opening drive, 3 straight runs, unable to pick up the first.
I know the fans want to see first downs, but guess what? The coaches have reasons for what they're doing. Sometimes they've scripted it, and some of these runs, while they haven't been successful now, they may be successful later on.
The punt team on now is from their end zone. They get it away. Taking a couple yards shy of midfield. A 39-yard punt, a return of 5. And the Lions will have excellent field position here as they take over first and 10. Back onto the field come the Lions for their second overall drive. First down, here's the run with Montgomery. And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. Call it no gain on the play, and it'll be second down.
The running lanes have definitely not been there for him here in the first half, and I don't think it's all been his fault. His offensive line hasn't given him much space. A loss results there.
Second and 10. Now it's gone. Goes out left. It's caught by Williams. And he's got this down to the 35. Second catch for him today, and it'll wind up a first down. Well, starting drive number two off on the right foot. Completion for the first down. Drive one is they had to be pretty frustrating because they moved the football. They just didn't get any points out of it.
But warm up QB two, let's bring in the backup. I mean, my goodness, you take them downfield and you don't score points. You know I'm being totally facetious here, right? I'm just kidding. Nice first drive. Rarely do teams score on every single drive in a game. But they like what they did there. They just hope they can pay it off this time with some points.
Well, prior to that, he had hit his first six passes to start the game, so on a nice little run to begin.
It feels like this offense has carried its dress rehearsal into the game, you know, because you do practice it. You do go through it. And in this case, it is clicking exactly like they drew it out.
Another throw on second down, and this one incomplete as well.
The coverage keyed in on him since that last completion his way. He earned a little more attention on that route, and that made it a lot tougher to get a clean throw his way.
So back-to-back incompletions, and that has him staring at a third and 10. Goff now looks to throw. Work in the middle of the field, and he's got a man complete. And this is going to lead to another first down as the tackle's made at the Bucs' 13-yard line. And they're able to convert on third with a solid gain of 23.
Well, that was a fun one to watch right there. A nice in-breaking route and plenty of room in the middle of the field. And he was able to get behind the linebackers and grab the completion for a really good pickup.
From the 13 now, they work on first and 10. From the red zone now, Goff. And his throw here is incomplete. Not sure what happened out there, but it looked like the timing was a little off on that throw.
Well, you know I'm a defender, so what am I going to say?
Great defense.
Darn right. They did something to disrupt that timing.
Here's second and 10. First run of the game for Jahmyr Gibbs, the Alabama product. And he'll get this one down to about the 10-yard line. He'll get only three there, so it leaves him with a third and seven ahead. Pretty good little two-play sequence there. You force the incompletion, then a very short pickup.
Yeah, now maybe you bring in an extra defensive back or two because you want to try and defend on third down. They like to play those nickel or sub packages, don't they?
Throwing on third, Goff. They'll set up the screen to Montgomery. And here he'll get it down to the seven. That's going to bring up fourth down, only a gain of two there.
Good reactions there defensively. That screen was a little slow in developing, and they shut that one down with little gain.
Here's Michael Badgley ready for the field goal try. From the left hash, should be a fairly easy one here. Badgley able to punch this one through, and the Lions are going to take a 3-0 lead. Well, both teams kind of feeling each other out here. Now after three drives, we have a score with that field goal.
Yeah, they're still waiting for their breakout drive to come to them, all right? They're using the playbook well. They're looking for that extra section that says touchdowns instead of field goals. But they'll take the three for now and try and get set up for more later.
Here are the Lions now as they line up and kick this one away. This fielded right at the goal line. And he's going to be taken down on what will be the final play of this first quarter. 3-0 after one on EA Sports. Second quarter now, and it's Buccaneer football. As they get set to start their drive with a first and 10. The Tampa offense ready to get their drive started. This one a little slow to get cooking, just a 3-0 scoreline as they begin with a first and 10. Here's a throw out wide complete to his running back right side. Call it a gain of six on the play, and it's second down.
Just about every quarterback is trained to really look downfield first before you come back and make a nice safe throw. And in this case, that's exactly what he did. Found his running back, let him create some space, and it turned out to be a nice play for the offense.
Here's Mayfield. And his throw's going to be incomplete.
Well, that's a defensive coordinator's got to be happy with that result. They took away all options downfield and forced the incompletion.
Now they face a third down and four after that incompletion on second down. Mayfield now. Able to find the open man. That's complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. How about 25 yards on third down? They'll take it.
So he turned to a trusted, familiar face in that third down situation. It paid off.
Yeah, you go to your veteran receiver in that spot, so you can't underestimate him when he's on the field. Defensively, make sure you know where he is because he understands how to get open in key situations.
So the ball moves into Lion territory now. Here's first and 10 at the 48-yard line. Mayfield throw on target to Godwin here. Short completion, just 4 yards, and that's going to bring up second down. Going to the air again with Mayfield. And an off-balance throw there, and it's going to wind up incomplete. They'll need to get this to the 38. That's where the first down marker is here on third. To throw, Mayfield. Before he crosses over out of bounds. They give him 27 yards on the third down conversion.
You think about the great receivers in the game, what do they have in common? The ability to create separation in their routes. Whether it's a head fake, a sharp cut, selling a different route, the subtle bump, it's a tough skill to teach. And this is well done here to get open and pick up the first down.
Three tight ends in the ball game here on first and 10. Looking Mike Evans' way again, and he's got another one. 2 yards on the pickup there, and that'll bring up second down.
The goal of a wide receiver screen is get enough blockers in front to create a wall and let him pick his spot to run the football. How about the defense there, swarming to it and not allowing that to happen? Did not let him get downfield.
This is second and 8. And now Mayfield on the bootleg. And in for the Buccaneers touchdown. Mike Evans, a 14-yard touchdown, and the Bucs have taken the lead.
As a former defender, I would be angry as well. Could not get off the field. Well-executed offensive drive, no matter what the defense tried, they couldn't stop them.
Chase McLaughlin on for the extra point. And this is up and good to make it 7-3. So that drive takes him down the field in 8 plays.
And it's Mike Evans who caps it with a touchdown reception.
Following the touchdown, here's McLaughlin to kick off. And he'll be tackled just shy of the 25.
Now the Lions offense, they get ready to head back out there. And last time they got 3 points, but it was a chip shot field goal. And when you go to the sideline after a chip shot field goal, maybe the offense not too happy.
It's a balancing act, isn't it? Because you're exactly right. They're none too pleased that they didn't punch it in for 6 points. But they also have to remember they did put points on the board.
3 points is 3 points.
And in this league, you take points when you can get them. Not easily done.
Now Goff on first down. He'll find Williams on the snap. And they're able to get this one across the 35. Nice way to start the drive. A gain of 12 and a first down.
You can see the time and effort and thought that they put into their passing game because it was evident right there. It looks like a simple pitch and catch, but you and I both know that they have planned for this and worked hard to make it happen.
They'll try the middle with Montgomery. And he puts his head down and gets up to the 42 for a gain of about 6.
If you're in the offensive huddle, you're smiling after that play because you've certainly got them guessing now. Second and short. Could they just hand it off for another big gain, or do they take advantage of this spot to take a big shot downfield?
From the 42-yard line, here's a second down and 4.
Now Goff. And this one incomplete. Too much contact to hold on to that one, and it's third down.
Normally being a big-bodied receiver plays to their advantage downfield. Go up and make the catch, take the hit, and pick up yardage. But in this case, the hit was timed really well and popped it free from his grasp.
From the gun on third down, Goff. He had a man open, but he missed him, and it's incomplete.
Well, the other day they told us when we've got third and 5 or less, we have to be able to convert. And I guess every team would say that, Charles, but an opportunity missed there.
What they were trying to tell us is they believe it's a matchup game at that point. And they liked some matchups that they had, thought they could exploit them, unable to do so on that play.
And here now the punter, Fox, as he sends this one away.
Fair catch called for and made at the 16 or maybe the 17-yard line. 37 yards on the punt with no return, and the Bucs will get ready to go on offense. And we shift to spotlighting Mike Evans. Last drive, the touchdown, 4 catches. Really good, he was. They were not good on the other side trying to stop him. What do they need to do?
Well, this is where the entire staff has to get involved because we always focus on the defensive coordinator. But he needs help from other people with their eyes and their expertise, and he needs to listen to them. And sometimes you just can't afford to wait on a drive and say, okay, let's get to the sidelines and start over. You need to find a way in the middle of that drive to start taking away what's hurting you.
Yeah, in-series adjustments, and how do you do that?
Well, what you do is you listen to what everyone else is telling you, what they're seeing, the patterns that are developing, and maybe you just start running extra bodies to take away that particular player. We use the word relentless a lot with guys who are aggressive on the field. In this case, it really fits, doesn't it? How about his ability to break tackles and his feet never stop moving?
Play fake, Mayfield. He's got a man complete. And he'll have it past midfield almost to the 40 before being taken down.
And two big plays right in succession as this one goes for 27.
Oh, I like that play call there. After a run for good yardage, you get a defense thinking they'll go back to the well. So that's a great time to call play action and give your receivers a little extra edge. And they complete the pass there for another first down.
So the ball moves into Lion territory now. Here's first and 10 at the 41. Mayfield looks to throw. And Mayfield will have a first down as he's able to slide to avoid the contact there at the end of the play.
That's over 40 yards of movement with those last two plays.
Certainly not the way they drew it up in the playbook, but that's why they love this guy back there. He sees things breaking down, and he's more than capable of finding an escape route and still getting a decent gain.
Mayfield off the play fake. He's going to let it go deep for the end zone.
Oh, and that is incomplete.
Well, a momentary speed bump there with that throw, partner. The defense had other ideas, and they're trying to mount a small stand before this drive reaches the end zone.
An incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25. Mayfield on play action.
And that went to the right side and incomplete.
But it looked like a march to the end zone has hit a momentary roadblock with that incompletion. No need to panic. They just got to come up with a high percentage play call and see if they can get their offense back on track.
This offense was on the move. Now two straight incompletions have them looking at third and 10. Mayfield. Looking for Godwin, and he's got him complete. And he's going to be marked down short of the first down, right around the 17. So 8 yards on the completion there, and that's going to bring up a fourth down.
Well, it looks like they got what they wanted. They got the completion, but they weren't able to break any tackles or gain nearly enough yardage to pick up the first down. Now it'll be fourth and short.
Mayfield to throw for it on fourth. He's got his target. That's complete. And he'll be taken down, but he does have first down yardage. Well, we kind of looked at each other as they decided to go for it, but in the end, great execution, a 6-yard gain, and it all works out.
So this drive going to continue following the conversion on fourth. Here's first and 10.
And again, it's Mayfield. Pass incomplete, but the flag in the backfield, and this might be a roughing call.
Yeah, no question. He got to the QB late, CD, and that's going to get a flag every time.
Every single time. Because let's face it, the league is always going to have an emphasis on these calls. They want to take care of these quarterbacks who are in vulnerable positions when they're passing the football.
They're going to run this with a tight end. And the hole closes quickly here. He can fight only to about the 4. It's a gain of a couple, and it'll be second and goal.
A lot can go wrong when you call a play like this down in the red zone, but that's where you appreciate this from your head coach. He's not afraid to trust his guys to do the right thing. And as a player, that means an awful lot.
On the ground with a tight end. And they will stop him after a fairly minimal pickup.
Third and goal now, mere inches from pay dirt. White. Diving for the end zone, and he is in. Touchdown. So they brought the extra bulk in down on the 1-yard line, and they're able to push this one across.
Yeah, I can just see your face right now because I know we're mind-melding on this one. Coach Madden would love this. Power football, hat on a hat, chest to chest, driving forward, touchdown.
McLaughlin now to add the PAT. And this one's right through to make it a 14-3 ball game. So that one, a pretty time-consuming 10-play drive.
And it was Rashad White who wrapped the drive up with a touchdown run.
Following the touchdown, here's McLaughlin to kick off.
Here comes Khalif Raymond from his end zone.
And no chance to get away as they'll get him down at about the 17-yard line. And Detroit getting set to go now. It's been very much a slow start for them. 3 drives and just the 3 points, CD.
Yeah, if you're into the points per drive ratio, that answer is 1. And that's not going to get it done in a ball game. They've got to find a way to finish these drives in end zones, not having balls go through goalposts.
On first down, Goff. And that is incomplete. He couldn't hold on through the contact. Brings up second down.
It's another zone defense. It looks like it's open for possibilities, but they did a nice job patrolling the middle of the field and forcing an incompletion.
An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. Gone.
A little short pass here taken in by Laporta.
They get 6. That'll leave them with 3rd and 4.
Brandon, perfect defense in this situation would have meant that there was an incompletion. They would have picked it off. Okay, so they gave up the completion. But I really enjoyed watching how the defense stayed in sync, stayed in great communication, and as he dragged across each zone, you see him pointing, communicating. There he is, and they passed him off to each defender, ended up making a nice play, even though it was complete.
Now a third down throw, but it misses the target, incomplete.
Not much going on this drive. Looks like they're going to have to punt it away, CD.
And right now, I know a lot of their fans are screaming for the OC to change things up, get away from what he's been calling. Sometimes you just need better execution of the plays that have been called.
On fourth down, the punt team is on as this is sent away. That'll be a 44-yard boot, just a yard on the return as he's covered up quickly.
And they will take over first and 10. Back now comes Tampa Bay. And with still more than a minute to go in the half, time to try to mount a drive.
And I would think that they would have to. This is today's NFL. You got to push it whenever you get an opportunity. You could never have enough points with the high-powered offenses that you face. And analytics will tell you, try and score when given the opportunity.
On first and 10, Mayfield.
The pass is caught by Kate Otten.
And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44. First play of the drive going for 14 and also going for a first down.
And what a nice example there of a tight end doing exactly what he needs to do. How about how he worked his way to the outside, made sure he secured the catch, and then anything after that, we count that as a bonus. And indeed, he gets enough for the first down.
First down, Mayfield.
And that nearly a turnover, but it's incomplete. Well, fortunate to retain possession there, and it's second down.
As a defensive back, you have some weapons at your disposal that we don't often talk about, and you can read the receiver's eyes, you can read his hands, and you know that the arrival of the ball is imminent, and that allows you to make a play on it and oftentimes knock it away.
Out route, and the ball is caught by Godwin. And he'll be corralled out across midfield down to the 45.
Now following the completion, we're going to get a stoppage here for an injury. Now the medical staff is going to come out here and take a look, and we will take a short break.
Mayfield with it once more. Evans has it left side. Now the Bucs going to use the first of their timeouts as it'll come with 36 ticks to go in half number one. So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. Mayfield to throw it. Throw right side, taken in by Godwin. And he is out of bounds inside the 30. They like going to him in the slot. He catches another one.
I think this comes under the heading of, until they stop him, why not go back to him? He has something going really well. Great working relationship with the guy throwing the ball, and they keep making the connection.
Now Mayfield.
That's completed right side to Palmer.
The Bucs going to go ahead and use the second of their timeouts. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime.
So here's a first and 10 now down inside the 20.
Going to the air again with Mayfield.
This one taken in by Otten.
And he's tackled a yard short of the marker. Good gain of 9 on first down.
Now that's staying ahead of the chains. Really good pickup on first down, hitting the tight end there. Now it brings up a second and manageable.
Just found a hole in that zone. And you see the clock almost empty, so this is likely the last play in the second quarter. And with just 4 seconds left in this first half, a timeout call. So with 4 seconds to go in the half, here's the field goal unit onto the field. From the left hash, a chip shot here.
And his kick is good. And they will stretch the lead now to 17-3. So a capper there to a pretty good first half.
And I love the way that they put a chokehold on the clock and pretty much drained everything before they put the field goal on the board as they headed into the half.
So barring a touchback, this likely the final act of the half as the kick is away. So we have reached halftime here with the visiting Buccaneers out on top. As we'll send you down to Orlando, and we check in with Jonathan Coachman for our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach.
Okay, Brandon, thanks very much. Back to you guys in a bit. But first, we welcome everyone to our EA Sports Halftime Report. It was a solid first half for the running back, Rashad White. He wound up finding the end zone on a touchdown run to help give his guys the advantage here at the break.
All right, Coach, thanks very much. Fine work as always as we welcome you back for quarter number three. ...17-3 the score as we resume action for the second half on EA Sports. From a couple yards deep, he'll bring it out of the end zone. And able to get this across the 20, but not much further as he's dropped it to 23-yard line. Now we're going to get a timeout. Appears we've got an injured Buccaneer. The medical staff will attend to him, and we will step aside. The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. This offense set to begin the third quarter, and Charles, if they had a checklist of things they wanted to accomplish in the first half, certainly at the top of that list would be having the lead, and they've got that here.
That's always the most important box to check, isn't it? But also, they've had some success in their passing game, so probably an empty box establishing the run. They're on pace for fewer than 100 yards in this one, so now they want to make sure that they get that going. So they truly have a control in this ball game, and down the stretch, being able to be balanced, either throw it or run it, and try to win this ball game.
And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. Five catches for him in that first half, and that's number six that we just saw, and also a first down.
Well, that certainly has to feel good, and it's not all the time that the play caller should get all the credit. Sometimes I think in the huddle, the quarterback just says, hey, who's going to make a play for me? I just need something right here. And the end result there, nice first down. Drive keeps moving.
First down, here's White. He'll get this to about the 38. In the first half, he was held in check on the ground, but despite that lack of production, they still have the lead.
Yeah, and they've got to feel fortunate about that. If they could actually get production from their lead horse, that would help open up this offense and widen this margin, too.
From the 38 now, here comes second and eight. They go play action, Mayfield. And this is dropped. Oh my goodness, there was no one around him, but he took his eye off it, and it falls incomplete.
And that's one of the few things that has not gone right in this offense so far. They've had their share of big plays. That was nearly another. But somehow, he just couldn't squeeze it.
On third down, Mayfield. And that is incomplete. So good coverage there defensively as it looks like they'll force a punt on this opening drive of the third.
Well, let's coach them up a little bit from right here in the booth. That's exactly what they needed to do. They need to start stringing together some stops, turning the ball over back to their offense, and trying to get back into this game.
Yeah, a couple scores down, but they can eat into that quickly with a nice drive here on the other side. This is brought in at the 21. A nice return there of 11 to help mitigate a good punt. And the Lions will take over. Now we take a glance at the offense as they work their way back out for their first possession of the second half. And Charles, they're certainly still right in this game, but they need that offense to wake up and in a hurry.
Yeah, I like the way you put it. They certainly did seem to sleepwalk a bit in the first half. Now that their defense has done its job, it's their turn now to go out and try and get some points.
They'll start on the ground with Montgomery. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. Great way to start the drive. 20 big ones and a first down.
Every team in the league always wants explosive plays, breakout plays, and even more so when it's your horse who's had a tough time during the game.
Yeah, not that great in the first half. Maybe he can recalibrate here in the third and then carry that over to the fourth.
I like that. Recalibrate. Strong.
On first down, it's gone. And his throw is going to be incomplete.
That certainly appeared to be a play call where they were just trying to make second down, second and short. I think they thought the coverage was off a little bit more than it was. Nice job there pressing up on it and forcing the incompletion.
So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. Back to throw, Goff. Throwing middle, but it's incomplete.
So many offenses want to include their running backs into their passing offense and be able to swing the ball out or check it down to them. But sometimes those guys are just not as comfortable catching the ball as they are running it.
So now third and 10. They had the big play to start the drive, but two incompletions since. Goff. He's got it with the 15. And he'll be taken down, but he does have first down yardage. A very nice pickup of 33 yards.
Well, as my dad would say sometimes, I'm just scratching my head here trying to figure out what was going on there defensively. How did you lose him in the middle of the field? If you're going to lose a receiver, make sure it's someone on the short side of things, not deep downfield, that can hurt your defense.
So after the big play, look at this, all the way down at the 15 now on first and 10. From the red zone now, Goff. That's complete to his tight end, Firkser. Yeah, that's good for a gain of 6, and that will bring up second down.
It certainly feels like there are more stars at the tight end position than there were even 10 years ago. And I think it's become more of a glamour position because of the ways it can hurt a defense, and guys want to be involved. They can be in line, close to the line of scrimmage. They can split out like receivers. But hands, route running, speed, and some toughness to go across the middle, you put it all together, you got a heck of a tight end candidate.
And the Lions are going to have a first and goal coming up as the tackle made at the 3-yard line.
That was a route run not just with dexterity, but with intelligence. Found the hole in the zone, made sure the quarterback saw him, and was able to make the sure catch and flip the down marker back to 1.
They'll run with Montgomery. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. It's a loss of 2 there, bringing up second down.
I would think down 2 scores at this point in the fourth quarter, even with the loss there on first down, this has got to be 4 down territory. If you're the field goal kicker, your only purpose now is if you can run out for a pass or actually carry the ball into the end zone. Otherwise, don't even look at the coach.
And he goes backwards on this one, losing yardage to the 7.
It'll be a loss of a couple on the play, so now third down coming up.
We all know how much running backs love getting the ball down near the goal line. They think they're going to find a way into the end zone. He hasn't had that kind of luck so far. Ends up not getting in on the last two carries. You know he's going to be upset about a missed opportunity.
Toward the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete. So now fourth and goal. You're trailing by a decent amount here. What are you doing, Coach Davis?
Well, I've got to think to myself, just how many more opportunities am I going to have this close and have this chance? I've got to go for it right here. The clock's dwindling on me. Let's go get it done.
Badgley able to knock this one through. And a second field goal here gets him back within 11 now. It's 17-6. So another good job defensively because they've allowed three trips into the red zone, but only the two field goals.
Yeah, that's the bend but don't break, isn't it? And they really didn't get broken at all because if you're running off the field having allowed of two field goals and three trips in the red zone, you've actually come out ahead.
Yeah, flip it over to the other side. The offense, they'll hope to cash in for six next trip. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. This taken in at the goal line. And tackled at the 21-yard line, so a net negative there of 4 yards. And Tampa Bay trots out there now. They had that first half lead, but they have been shut down here in this third quarter, so time to retool a bit.
And probably need to tap into that emotional vein that gets them back to really playing hard and effectively. Because a lot of times we think it's just play calls and this isn't working and they're shutting them down. Sometimes when you get a lead, you lose your edge. You don't play quite as hard. That's what they're looking for here.
Trying to get that edge back as they watch this lead shrink a little. And he's able to plow forward up to about the 29, just shy of the 30. A solid run on first down. Gain of 7 leaves him with a 2nd and 3. They stay on the ground with White. 7 yards there and a first down.
Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football, sustained runs, taking their time and making it work.
So from the 36 now, 1st and 10. From the shotgun, it's Mayfield. Throwing quickly there, but it's incomplete.
I think he's got to be careful not to force anything into coverage right there. There weren't really any throwing lanes, but the best part for him, he's got 2nd and 3rd down to fall back on.
They'll try again from the 36 on 2nd and 10. They run straight ahead here with White. 49 yards on the ground for him now on 9 carries.
That was good, tough running right up the middle. And if the defense can't penetrate and make him slow his pace or change direction, that's often the end result.
Couple of first downs to kick off the drive. Here's 1st and 10 up at the 46. Working out of the gun, Mayfield. That is caught. It's Chris Godwin. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. 28 yards the gain there on the catch and run.
That's another beautiful throw right there. Gets it to his man right in stride. And I think that throw kind of exemplifies what we've seen from this offense throughout this game. They've been in rhythm. They've been sharp. They've been on it. And they pick up another first down there.
So the ball moves into Lion territory now. Here's 1st and 10 at the 26-yard line. Meanwhile, Mayfield's throw taken in by Evans here. And down inside the 15, shy of the 10. Back-to-back nice gains, that one for 14 yards and another first. Now back to the ground game with White. And a pickup of about 4 down inside the 10 to the 8-yard line.
Not a run that you're going to write home about, but still a good first down run. That's what an offense calls staying on schedule. 3 to 4 yards on first down, you're set up very well for the rest of the drive.
Facing a 2nd and 6 from the 8. Mayfield down. And this one is going to be off the mark, too far out in front.
Well, touch and timing are critical for those types of throws. He put a lot of zip on that one. Needed just a little bit more finesse trying to get it to his back.
And they'll be in search of 6 yards here on 3rd down. This is now the 9th play of the drive. Here's Mayfield. And Evans hauls it in. Touchdown, Bucks. Mike Evans, his 2nd touchdown of the afternoon.
And the Bucs will add on to their lead here in the final minute of the 3rd.
That drive that really increased their cushion felt very military to me. Very precise, methodical, that's one of the words you've taught me. And they just got it done.
And slowly but surely now starting to pull away a little bit. Things looking good for them here in the 3rd quarter.
Not only pulling away, but you mentioned that slowly but surely. You also drain clock, too, with a drive like that. So you really give yourself an advantage.
Following the touchdown, here's McLaughlin to kick off. Here's Raymond bringing it out. And he will be brought down here inside the 20. Good coverage as he's dropped at the 17. The Lions offense set to take over.
Their drive last time, it stalled out. They were forced to take the short field goal.
And the key phrase, you nailed it. Forced to, because you know coaches look at these short field goals as a last resort, right? To them, that's not how drives are supposed to end. You're supposed to put 6 on the board. That's a consolation prize, like going to the county fair. You don't get a big stuffed animal on that one, do you?
No, you don't go top shelf. That's bottom shelf material. To Montgomery to begin the drive. And a nice stiff arm. It opens room to run. And they'll get it all the way up about 5 yards shy of midfield.
61 yards rushing for him now on what was his 10th carry of the ball game.
They had a chance to limit his yardage, but he was able to fight off that tackle.
So it's not just the responsibility of the guys who missed the tackles along the way. It's all 11 on defense, able to stop this guy, unable to do it on that play. They've got to find a way. How about his ability to break through and gain that yardage?
And now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete.
That was a nice job defensively of disguising their coverage and making it difficult for the quarterback to lock in on a receiver, and it results in an incomplete pass.
After the incomplete pass, here now is 2nd and 10. Up the middle, it's Montgomery shedding through the defense and taking it across midfield and inside the 45. Three quarters in the books. This is the National Football League on EA Sports. Back now at Ford Field. It's the Lions trailing, but with possession of the football as we get set to bring you the 4th quarter. On 1st and 10, here's Gibbs. And he's going to be down at the 35, gain of 7.
Well, no matter how they phrase it, staying on schedule, staying ahead of the sticks, whatever you want to call it, 7 yards on 1st down, that fits the bill.
From the 35, here's 2nd and 3.
Goff now to throw. Wright's got it. And this is going to lead to another 1st down as the tackle's made at the Bucs' 22-yard line. They give him 13 yards there on the play and a fresh set of downs.
A 3-score game here late. You can probably rule out the comeback, but certainly some kind of a moral victory to be had if they can get a few more points to close things out. And to that end, a nice pass play there to push things downfield.
Yeah, and we know in this league,
a loss is a loss, and no one wants anything to count as a moral victory or, boy, something that feels a little bit cheap. But if they trim that lead down to just two scores, that's still a benefit to this squad.
2 yards to go, second down.
They'll keep pounding here with Montgomery. Trying to run inside, but nothing there. He got maybe a half yard at most, but officially they'll be left with a 3rd and 2. The good run on first down followed up by a not-so-good run on second down.
Now let's find out if they're going to stick with the run here on third down. A lot of people would love to see some play action here. I say go with your best running play over your best blocker.
3rd and 2. Goff.
He's got his running back out of the backfield. And the Lions are going to have 1st and goal coming up as they're able to convert there on 3rd and 2.
Well, they've had a great, impressive drive going here, and that pickup ensures the drive continues.
And not only do you continue the drive, which is demoralizing for the guys on the defensive side of the ball right now, but you make your own defense happy. They're able to get a little more rest over on the sidelines while this one continues downfield.
Going up the gut, Montgomery. And he's able to get it down to the 2-yard line. A pickup of 4 on first down. It'll be 2nd and goal. They're mounting a nice drive here. Good chunk of yardage there again. O-line, they've been solid this drive.
They have that look about them right now that says, if you do anything but run the ball behind us, you're crazy. They have really moved it well on this drive, and they want to finish it off the same way.
Once more, Montgomery,
and he'll take this into the end zone. Now, hold on here. We do have a flag down, so let's see what this is about. So reverse the celebration. We'll see if they have something else in their bag of tricks.
And isn't that always tough to watch when they score and you see the excitement, and then when they realize those points aren't going to count? Can they get it back together and find their way back to the end zone?
A crucial penalty there as the hold backs them up for another 2nd and goal. Gone.
That's complete to Laporta.
Only able to pick up 2, and that leads us to 3rd and goal.
Not a big window to throw. Coverage wasn't too bad there.
Yeah, they had him under wraps pretty well, but somehow able to muscle his way open and catch the ball.
This defense has not surrendered a touchdown yet. You better believe they're determined not to here on 3rd and goal. Now gone. And that is caught. Touchdown, Detroit.
Jared Goff to Amon-Ra St. Brown. And the Lions are finally into the end zone here in this 4th quarter.
So a little bit of a letdown there defensively. I mean, look, you're still 2 scores to the good, CD, but things may be a little more uncomfortable than they had hoped.
Yeah, if you'd kept them out of the end zone there, this game's over. You've locked the door on them. Instead, it's still open a little bit, and they've got a puncher's chance.
Extra point by Badgley, up and good. And that makes it 24-13. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away.
Taken at the goal line.
And he'll be brought down shy of the 20, so the decision to bring it out of the end zone, not a good one.
Mike Evans of the Tampa offense about to set up shop.
And I know that they've double-teamed him a couple times, but not a ton. Whatever they're doing isn't working. He's up over 100 yards. We'll see how they adjust.
And when they do that, they weaken their defense in other places as well. And how many times have we done games where we've seen a guy have a big game like this? But it's usually not by himself, is it?
Right.
Usually it opens it up for other people to have big games as well.
Now Mayfield and the Bucs come up on 1st and 10
at their own 18. They'll start out here with the option left. And he probably should have given that one off as he's going to get hit and taken down behind the line.
He'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11.
And on this play, the read for the quarterback was the defensive end, and he was totally focused on the quarterback. He should have given it off inside to the running back. Instead, he kept it and ended up taking a loss on the play.
On second down, they'll run with White, and he'll take this up only to about his 18-yard line. The second down play, not much better than the first, just a gain of one there. This defense starting to buckle down when they need to, and right now they're winning this fourth quarter, losing the game, but they're winning in the fourth quarter.
And what a fine line it is about what they're trying to get done, because they're down, so they obviously need the football, need a score, but they can't be so aggressive as to give up their...
And he's going to be brought down, back at his own 6-yard line. Aiden Hutchinson able to get him down for a loss of 11, and it brings up fourth down.
Now that was a passer's nightmare. The front door totally shut down by the defense, so he kept going backwards, hoping to find another avenue of escape. It didn't exist.
Here comes the Buccaneers punter now. As the drive goes backwards, so he's on to punt it away. And a fair catch called for and taken right on the midfield stripe. Yeah, call it 38 yards on the punt, no return. And this offense, they're going to have excellent field position. They take over with a first and 10 on the short side of the field. First down, Goff. And that one drops down, incomplete. Good coverage there, forced the ball free, and it's second down.
He did a fine job there of not hitting him before the ball arrived, and I've got to tell you, you can often mistime that play because of the angles of approach. When you're going to get him, sometimes you panic as well and think, I've got to be there right now. Instead, in this case, timed it perfectly and knocked it free.
That's going to be caught by Josh Reynolds. 9 yards, not quite enough, and they'll be left now with third and one. And they're going to hurry back to the line now. Goff wants to throw on third and one. This one swung out to Montgomery. And he is going to have a Lions first down by about a yard as they're able to convert on third and two.
Short yardage situation. You have to wonder if they thought that they were just going to run it inside. But you have to be cognizant of the back slipping out in the backfield trying to find some open space. And that's exactly what he does to the tune of a first down.
On first and 10, Goff. And oh, that nearly their first pick of the game, but it falls down to the ground incomplete.
Oh, this defense knows. Fourth quarter, they need to make a play. That one was ripe for the taking. Could have changed the complexion of the ball game, but it winds up incomplete.
Line of scrimmage, again the 37 as they line up second and 10. From the gun, here's Goff. He's going to let this go. Back of the end zone. And that's going to be incomplete. Good effort there, trying to take a shot, but it's third down.
And they're at the point of the ball game now where they've got to take some chances. They've got to put the ball in the air and just see what happens. But this defense knows that all too well.
And this offense on third down today, they've hit on half of them, 5 for 10. This is third and 10. Throwing again is gone. Pass taken in by his big tight end. And all the way to the 2-yard line there before crossing over out of bounds. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal.
Despite writing it down on my notes, I never give enough credit to the offensive line, and we have to here. The protection, that's what made this play a success. Quarterback had to wait for his crossing route to develop, and that takes a little bit of extra time. Excellent job by the big fellas up front.
Now a throw to the end zone on first down, but it winds up incomplete. Down this close to the goal line, first down. Surprised that wasn't a run?
I am, and you know I'm old school. I want to run the ball on first down in this situation because second down, that gives me an option of running play action and maybe throwing it.
Second and goal, and they will try again from the 2-yard line. Here's Goff. Open man, and he's got Williams. Touchdown, Lions. 2 yards on the touchdown there. And the Lions have made it a one-score game again here in the fourth. An out route there for the score, a quick out route there for the score.
Yeah, you're not really surveying the defense on this one. You're just counting on timing, making this play happen. 1-2, ball's out of his hands, knows where he's going, just puts it to the outside. Touchdown.
Goff looking to throw. And this is caught. They got it. And that could be an important 2 points. It gets him back within a field goal. Well, I guess the coach looked at the 2-point cheat sheet, said go for it, get it to a 3-point game, and they did it.
Yeah, sometimes you just throw out time of game. You don't worry about that. There's just a feel sometimes in making that call, and he felt good about what he had for a 2-point conversion, and now they're only down 3 and feeling great about themselves.
Here are the Lions now as they line up and kick this one away. And not much happening on the return as he'll get this to about the 23. The Bucs ready to take over once again. And with that last touchdown, I mean, we're set up for a good finish here. Some things to consider, Charles. Obviously, it's a very close game. You're in the fourth quarter. Defensively, they've got all 3 timeouts in their back pocket.
So the chess match really ramps up, doesn't it? Because in these situations, what do? Do you run the ball and kill the clock here? Or do you try and bury them with another score? And how about defensively? Do you use your timeouts as early as opportunity? Or wait till you hit the 2-minute warning? So there's a lot going into this one. Let's see how each side goes about their strategy.
Derek Barnes came in there hard on the blitz and got him down 9 yards behind the line of scrimmage. Blitz came there from the inside, and there just wasn't much resistance.
No, not at all. That means that defensively, they timed it up perfectly and matched up perfectly. They drew all the blockers to the other guys, left a free runner back to the quarterback. And you know what a free runner turns into?
What?
A free hitter.
They'll go up the middle with White. And he finds enough of an opening to get this one back up to his 20. And now we'll see a timeout used on defense as they stop it right out of the break with 1:57 to go in the ballgame. This is a big third down, and you'd have to think we'd see a timeout right away if they can't stop them here. Try to take this home, no run. And he'll be brought down at the 28, and that is well short of the first. The Lions now going to use the second of their timeouts. That'll leave them with just 1 remaining in this fourth quarter of play. Here comes the Buccaneers punter now, as he'll punt it away for the 4th time today. This is fielded at the 27. It'll go as a 42, making a 43-yard punt. 6 on the return, and out will come the offense as they take over. So here's Goff and the Lions. Down 24-21, 1:44 to go. How will this thing pan out? We'll watch as they come up on first down. Now it's Goff. Throwing left sideline there, but it's incomplete.
Work with me, partner. Take a deep breath, because that's what they're doing down the field now. That incompletion allowed them to exhale a little bit. Get in the huddle, kind of scan the crowd, see if any celebrities are here. Relax a little bit as they start this big drive.
Another try, 2nd and 10 now.
Now Goff. Looking left side and he's got a man. That's Gibbs. Nothing open downfield. They went underneath.
Yeah, see if you can get it to your running back. See if you can make someone miss in the open field.
Here now, third down.
Goff now to throw. Working in the middle of the field, and he's got a man complete. And they'll get this well past midfield before being stopped just before the 35.
That's a nice job right there, partner, because they were able to work down the middle of the field, working in the seams, because I think defensively, they were guarding the sidelines, trying to keep them from getting out of bounds. They took what they gave them, and it was successful.
Goff. That is caught. Josh Reynolds. And all the way inside the 15 before they drop it. He's been quiet all afternoon. He may have just come up with a play of the day right there, though.
Obviously, it's not the volume in what you get done. It's the quality, and that was a quality catch right there.
Well, this offense still has the one timeout here, remember. First and 10.
Yeah, he's got it. And so close, he gets it to the one. Out of bounds right there. That's what they need right now. Get the first down, get out of bounds, stop the clock.
Just playing smart football, understanding the situation, making the plays necessary, and making sure that clock stops at every opportunity.
Montgomery will take this one in. It's a Lions touchdown. Charles, that drive was perfect, methodical, executed so well, and they grabbed that lead with almost no time left for a last gasp from the other side.
No way you could have drawn up a better final drive, because not only did they keep their eyes on the end zone, they made sure they bled the clock out as well and denied their opponent a chance to respond. That's just terrific situational football to end this one.
Extra point by Badgley, up and good. And it would appear, barring some late heroics, they're going to get out of here with a come-from-behind victory. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes.
And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. They'll come up first and 10 here.
One last shot from Mayfield here.
That's complete to Otten.
And he gets this up just shy of the 30 to the 29 before he's out of bounds.
Well, it took us until the final play, Charles, to officially decide a winner, although on that last play they were so backed up it would have taken a miracle, and they couldn't get that miracle done.
Well, I like how you stayed with it, because we both knew that this had to go down to the last play, and neither side was going to exhale until that play concluded, because we've seen the improbable before. A couple of laterals, maybe some poor defense on the back end. They might have gone all the way to the end zone. In this case, though, it didn't happen. Perhaps next time.
That'll do it for us. For Charles Davis and all our hardworking crew, I'm Brandon Gaudin. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. For more, find us on Twitter at EA Madden NFL. It's a win for the Lions as we say so long from Ford Field.